Chapter 7. Howdy, Journal. Applejack washed off her hose under the barn water spigot and headed upstairs to her bedroom. She hung her hat on the peg and looked around the room. What now? How did a pony go about relaxing? Her eyes scanned the room and landed on a basket in the corner brimming with different colored yarn. I know. I'll work on that blanket I was knitting for Apple Bloom, Applejack announced to No Pony. It was going to be the perfect relaxing activity to take her mind off of this award hullabaloo. She chose some green yarn and found a little piece from the last time she'd worked on it. Apparently that was a long time ago, because she could barely remember how to knit. The more Applejack tried to loop and purl, the more the yarn became a big tangled mess. Jumpin' jackrabbits! Applejack exclaimed. This was the exact opposite of calming. What was she doing wrong? Was it loop cast stitch or loop stitch cast? Or neither? She scratched her head, examining the jumbled ball of yarn in front of her. Suddenly, she remembered the knitting guidebook Twilight had given her last spring. Why, it had all the instructions she needed to make the blanket and more. With that thing by her side, she'd even have time to knit a few sweet apple acres cider cozies to impress the judges. Applejack rifled under the bed, where she kept all her odds and ends that didn't belong anywhere else. She didn't see the knitting book, but another book caught her attention instead. It was her mother's drawing book. She hesitated for a moment, and then decided to pull out the big leather tome. Applejack grabbed a quill from her nightstand drawer and plopped down on her bed. She flipped through the pages until she found a blank page. Applejack began to write. How to journal. Today, like any other day, I guess. Today started like any other day, I guess. Me and the other apples got up bright and early and such. I was ready for a productive day on the farm. I had a lot of trees to buck, and was excited to do it. See, I had a bee in my bonnet about how I was going to get everything done, because it's special week. Sweet Apple Acres is up for an award. Best orchard in Equestria. Pretty neat, huh? Applejack stopped scribbling for a moment. She was starting to feel more relaxed already. Granny Smith was right. Applejack turned her attention back to the page and continued on. So of course I wanted to win. Need to win. When I told my friends about it, they kindly offered to help me get things ready around the farm. Now, I'm not one to turn down a pony who wants to work, except that one time I tried to buck all Sweet Apple Acres on my own. But we all remember how that turned out. So I accepted. Today was Pinkie Pie's turn. Don't get me wrong, I love Pinkie as much as a grub slinger loves a new spatula. But the trouble is, she's an awful farm worker. Maybe the worst I've seen. All day long she was running to and fro, jabbering on, and just slowing me down. But she wasn't. If she wasn't around, I might have gotten all my work done. But now I'm real behind. Pinkie Pie's quote-unquote help was just the opposite. What a pickle. Oh well, I guess tomorrow's a new day. The tired pony left out a deep sigh. Riding sure felt good. It was like all the frustrations of the day had just left her. Poof. Granny was right. She was getting her lasso in a twist over a whole lot of nothing. It hit her like a crate of apples, but all of a sudden, the pony was plumb knackered. Applejack gingerly closed the book and put it on the nightstand on top of the journal she shared with her friends. She flicked off the lamp and soon fell into a deep, dreamless sleep.